If there is an acute morbidity requiring euglycemia for proper treatment, like infection or trauma, again, intensive insulin therapy is the best. You can try premixed, but basal will not work. But if there is high risk of hypoglycemia, then basal would be the drug of choice or the regimen of choice. Another challenge that we face in the developing world is we have to handle all this together. So half of the patients who come to us have diabetes as a chronic disease. So we are there with them. We take them through the natural history of diabetes. This is similar to what our colleagues in the West face. But another problem that we face, and this can be understood only by a doctor from Myanmar or South Asia. Most of the patients who come to our clinic present with diabetes as an acute illness. They have either a symptom or a sign or a laboratory abnormality which needs acute intervention. So we have to handle these in a different manner. So our mind is the same, but we have to change our hats, we have to change our turbans according to the patient's need. If the patient has come in with diabetes as an acute illness, we handle in an emergency manner. If the patient has come in with chronic condition or syndrome, then you handle in a chronic and slow, relaxed manner. Here also, we are answerable to our patient. And let me take a few minutes to discuss healthcare seeking behavior. This slide will become easy to understand when we look at this particular slide. According to ADA-ESD guidelines, it is assumed that every patient with diabetes will behave in a very nice manner. The moment diabetes is diagnosed, the patient will come to us, come to our clinic. The patient will remain with the same doctor for the next 20, 30 years. And gradually, as time goes by, the beta cell deficit will increase. As time goes by, the intensification of insulin and oral drugs will increase. So if the patient came to me in year 2000, maybe he was on lifestyle modification. By the year 2030, the patient will still be coming to me, and by that time, he will be on basal bolus therapy. And this is how the guidelines tell us to work. But this does not happen in India and in Myanmar. This is what we see, in India at least. Patient comes in with an acute illness, which may be infection, it may be a surgical morbidity, it may be trauma. Here you have to treat intensively. But after some time, you see that the glucotoxicity and the lipotoxicity go down, and you are actually able to downgrade therapy. So maybe here I give basal bolus insulin therapy to correct tuberculosis. But once the TB is okay or the intensive phase is okay, then I don't need to give basal bolus throughout. Patient can come back to premixed insulin, maybe even to metformin glimepiride. And then life goes on smoothly. If this was the case, even that would be fine. But in my country, this is what I see most often. And this is called a yo-yo pattern or a sawtooth pattern. So patient comes in with ulcer on the left foot. We manage diabetes with insulin. We put the patient on premixed and send him back. And then the patient is lost to follow-up. After 3 years, the patient comes again. Doctor, now I have a new disease. So you say, what is the new disease? You had diabetes 5 years ago, now also you have it. So the answer is, no, sir. Last time I had left foot ulcer, now I have a right foot ulcer. Now please fix it again. So this yo-yo kind of thing keeps on going on. Yet another one, this was prevalent in my medical college. So suppose in 1990, my head of department medicine prescribed glibenclamide 5 milligram BD. Now, professor retired in year 2000, but nobody dare say anything to professor, sir. So still my patient is taking glibenclamide 5 milligram BD because the professor had written, so we will not change, no matter what happens to HbA1c or sugars. Once we understand this, and we also understand racial and ethnic differences in our patients, we can then understand that our decision of an insulin regimen and our decision of an insulin preparation should be based upon factors that are specific to our country. So we must read the ADA-ACE guidelines, but we must understand the background that those authors have, and we must understand the kind of patients that those authors see. We must also correlate with the kind of patients that we see with the healthcare seeking behavior of our patients, and then take appropriate decisions. So therefore, we can base our recommendations for insulin on ethnicity and also upon healthcare seeking behavior.
Zifam, caring for well-being.